I know what you're trying to do.
I'm trying to free your mind, Neo. But I can only show you the door. You're the one that has to walk through it.
Hey, Shalom family. It's your boy, Pac Ray, aka Perez Jow from the Rumble Room. Hey, listen, I didn't want to be long. I just wanted to send a little update. And there is an opportunity where I believe we can really make an impact and send a message to the urban apologist movement. I'm talking about Vocab, Cherry, Faithful to God, all those deviant apologists who have been acting insensibly and irrationally. I mean, with or without the debate, we're good. We know who we are. It's them who want the dialogue. It's them who are acting uncharitably and insensibly and irrationally, mocking, avoiding, shouting, not facilitating, not promoting meaningful, fair, and balanced dialogue. These people purport themselves to be apologists, but they are not apologists at all. They are pseudo-apologists. And it seems that the Christian world has taken notice as well. Bobby Conway of One Minute Apologists, who I reference in many of my videos, he raised the question to Vocab, is there a place for satire and mockery within apologetics? And of course, the sensible person who knows apologetics, who has been keeping their eyes on the apologetic game, knows that, of course not, there is no place for satire and mockery in apologetics. And regarding charitable dialogue, there is no place for mockery. There is no place for ignoring, shouting down, shouting over, not letting people speak. This type of thing needs to be addressed. And I mean, like I said before, we're good either way. It's them who needs the dialogue. But I really feel like we'll be able to really show the online community, the Hebrew, those who are paying attention to the Hebrew Christian debate, will really be able to reposition ourselves in this ongoing dialogue as a community who wants to dialogue, who is willing to dialogue and is willing to defend what they believe. Okay. How is it that you're the apologist and you're coming against the Hebrew Israelite community, but the Hebrew Israelite community wants to dialogue, wants to have the conversations, but now you're not being reasonable and sensible enough to have the conversation, okay? This is the time to really rally together and strike. So in light of Bobby Conway questioning Vocab, and in light of multiple notable apologists have noted it, and now I believe it's come to a head. So what's the plan, you ask? Hank Hanegraaff, leading Christian apologist in the game, has posted on his website a post where he is taking entries for questions for his show. Okay, so if you go to his YouTube page, Bible Answer Man, type in Bible Answer Man in the search box, and you go to discussion, and it should be a discussion on the desktop, and on your phones, on the mobile, it should say community. You go to either of those sections, you'll see a post where he's taking questions. It says, we want to answer the YouTube community's questions in our content. Please help us out and Happy New Year. Okay, then below there's a blue picture with light blue writing saying Happy New Year. Your input is needed in the comments below. List your questions. List your questions you want Hank to answer on the Bible Answer Man broadcast. Now, since this is an open request, how cool would it be for Hank to address mockery and satire and apologetics on his show? Okay, now you say, well, it's not guaranteed, right? Well, no, it's not guaranteed. But if we rally together as a community and we flood that post with the critical question, is mockery and satire appropriate for apologetics? Does mockery and satire have a place in Christian apologetics? Perhaps we can get Hank to address the issue and to perhaps bring some accountability to these shield squadder individuals. Okay, Vocab Malone, Faithful to God, Cherry Love, and affiliates like David Wood. Perhaps we can bring some accountability to those individuals. So if you access that website and you go to that post, you'll see an entry by the Biblical Rumble Room. It says, does mockery and satire ad hominem fallacies like those produced by Vocab Malone and Dr. David Wood, Acts 17 Apologetics, which is his YouTube page, does mockery and satire actually have a place in Christian apologetics and interfaith dialogue? Now, if you'd like, please feel free to copy and paste that or copy and reword. But all you really have to do, brothers and sisters, is click that like button right under that comment. That way, when Hank and his team see all the likes, all the thumbs up for that comment, if he sees maybe four or five different comments that are that demand a response, perhaps he will bring some accountability on his Bible Answer Man broadcast. And that would be crucial. That'd be a hard hit, because we know Vocab Malone admires Hank Hanegraaff. We know Hank Hanegraaff is the premier face of the Christian apologetics movement. Okay, so if you go there and you click that like right under the Biblical Rumble Room's comment, and maybe add your own, and just spread the word far and wide, and I believe we can perhaps have a chance to get Hank Hanegraaff's attention to address these shenanigans that are going on that really should just stop, you know. And if not for the sake of their own religion, like I have no dog in the fight as far as Christianity goes, but hey, I believe in constructive interfaith dialogue. If there are apologists that don't want to have interfaith dialogue, then what are you doing calling yourself an apologist? Okay, if satire and mockery is all you have left in the game, then just put a fork in yourself. You're done. Go to sleep. Okay, so if we rally together and we come together as a community, I believe we can really sort of send the urban apologetics movement a message, and Christian apologetics as a whole. Above all, it would send a message to the rest of those who are maybe speculating on the sidelines, who may be Christian, who may not be Christian, those who are new to the truth. They will be able to see us stand tall and stand strong and demand accountability to these Christians who basically picked the fight with us to begin with. All right. So, family, if you can get on over to that Bible Answer Man website and YouTube and click that like and maybe add one or two questions of your own, at the very least, just click the like. That way we show solidarity and support for bringing accountability to these urban apologists who are running rampant, just running wild right now. I believe that would be a really good motion, a really good move for our cause. Okay, I hope you guys are well and blessed, and I will see you in the Rumble Room. Peace, light, shalom.
I know what you're trying to do. I'm trying to free your mind, Neo, but I can only show you the door. You're the one that has to walk through it.